Hello everyone, I'm Chris, and today we'll have a deep dive in the connectivity add-on with Winmod in KUKA.Sim. In the first part, we will write a little program to manually change the values of axis 1 of a robot in Winmod. Then you will learn how to connect it to the simulation in KUKA.Sim and move the robot around in the simulation throughout Winmod. Let's jump back into Winmod.
First, we open a new project, and we are going to have this Winmod project, but we also need a new simulation. Before we create operators, we're going to save it real quick under the name of connectivity. Go, and now I can actually add operators, but we also want the library because we're going to add a little logic. With this two windows, I can start off. You can create a new operator, for example, an analog A1. So this is for our analog signal for the axis 1. So if we do this, we can directly find the operator here, and we're going to add a second one, which is going to be our output digital signal for A1, and this is going to be this digital value. And we're going to create a third one, which is going to be our in digital A1. Also very important in this case to actually move our robot over our WinMod simulation. So what we're going to do next, we're going to use from the signal elements the analog signal, where we are going to use it for the analog A1. So you can take over these settings and then just press OK. And we're going to add a converter from analog to digital, which is going to be useful to actually change our axis 1 from our input, which is going to be our local operator analog 1 that you already have above. And our output is going to be the output digital A1. We're going to add a little digital display so that we see at which value we are currently at. And we're also going to take this out digital 1 so that we can see from our axis 1 what is the current status. You can take over the values here. And now we can start the project, and you will see that as soon as we move the slider here from left to right, it goes from minus 185 to plus 185. Redo the settings, I can force it or not, and we just don't want to force the active signal, so we want to get it the slider here. And with that, we can actually continue, because we need our signal actually then to be handed out to KUKA.Sim. So we need this communication element for the controller. I'm just going to change the settings. So we have to change it that our connection is allowed here. Then on the properties here of this communication element, we are going to rename it to communication. We're going to send the following value. So we're going to look again for our out analog or out A1, and it's going to be this digit value, and we're going to set it to our out digital A1. And again, we can receive a signal, which is going to be our in A1. It's also going to be digital, and we select again the in digital A1. So this is our communication platform right now. Just going to correct here the axis 1. This is going to be the in A1 for this variable for the digital display. Now, if I connect it to KUKA.Sim, we have to go to a connectivity add-on, go to Winmod, add a new server. We first have to activate the connection so we can test it on the right side and then take it over and then activate it with the mouse click here on this circle. And then we have to connect our variables. So if we add this variable for the A1, we're going to look for the server side, directly finds the out A1 and in A1. And as soon as I go here to the KR120 to the values, I can jump to the out A1 and the value that I already added, and now just connect it. And the other variables from the simulation to the server is going to be also the same value. So now I have the simulation to the server is the value to the A1 in A1, and also the value to the out A1. And if I press play, you directly see the robot jumped into another position because I already have a written value in WinMod. And if I'm just going to switch my view so I can properly see what is happening on the WinMod side and on the simulation side, I can show you that by moving the slider here from left to right, you can change the values and actually the robot moves as expected. So this is a thing that you can now do with any of your little projects, and this will help you a lot.
Thank you for watching this video. If you would like to see more interesting videos about KUKA's simulation world, feel free to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. Looking forward to seeing you in the next video.
Industrial intelligence.